This is NSLX1. Unlike many lazy engravers that require you to learn complicated software and machine operations, this one feels like it has a small brain of its own. You simply preview the final result in the software, and it automatically adjusts all the parameters for you. It features dual 8-megapixel cameras for real-time imaging, a laser module with autofocus, and blazing fast engraving speed. The massive work area gives you room to create freely. And most importantly, the final engraving looks exactly like the software preview. It's a truly hassle-free laser engraver, perfect for beginners and small studios alike. I was given early access to the prototype of the NSLX1 and have been using it over the past few weeks to create some great pieces. Here's my in-depth review. Here's how it looks. The dimensions are 903 by 787 by 213.5mm. It features a fully enclosed design that meets Class 1 safety standards. One of the biggest highlights of the X1 is the built-in dual screens on the front panel. One shows the real-time PM value, and the other displays machine status and engraving progress. But it gets cooler. It supports live sync motion control. You can move the laser head directly and the canvas on screen will sync, or drag the design and the laser head will follow. The screen runs a powerful Linux-based system, allowing for standalone operation, no PC needed. Lift the lid and you'll find the dual 8-megapixel cameras used for real-time imaging and positioning. The laser module is swappable, available in 20 watts, 40 watts, and 60 watts variants. And it's super easy to change. Speaking of which, let's talk a little bit more about the software. Yes, it supports LiDAR, but I want to get into that since some of you probably know it better than I do. Instead, let's look at a self-developed app, AlienSail Space. Here's the interface. It's still in the early stages, but it already handles basic tasks. What I really want to show you is this exclusive real-time simulation feature. Choose live view, and the camera will automatically take a photo, import the image you want to engrave, adjust the size to match your material, and set the thickness. Then select a material preview. This gives you a realistic preview of how the engraving will look in your material. Adjust the effect by dragging the slider to deepen or lighten as needed. Once you are satisfied, you can even lock the effect and tweak the power or speed. Want to go faster? The power adjusts automatically. Magic, right? If you want to engrave even more refined, go to design to adjust the brightness, contrast, etc. After everything's set, just hit the process and then press start on the machine. It's that easy. Wondering how the machine handles focusing? No worries, it's all automatic. The probe is released, the laser head moves down to detect the correct focal point, then retract the probe and begins engraving. Here is the final result. So, how does it compare to the software preview? Well, I place them side by side. I let you be the judge. They are really close, right? The contrast and shading are nearly identical. I love it. But what I really want to focus on is the engraving performance. Here we did a side-by-side test using a 48 watts laser from another brand. To be fair, both use LiDAR for path planning with a speed set to 600 mm per second and output power at 36 watts. And the same line spacing was used. And here are the results. The other machine took about 1 hour and 55 minutes, while the X1 finished in just 30 minutes. That's 80 minutes less! So, same speed, same power, why such a huge difference? I'd say this is likely due to what they advertised. The X1's acceleration reaches 20,000 mm per second squared, meaning it hits 600 mm per second in just 0.3 seconds. Now let's look at the actual engraving result. Because if faster speed means worse quality, it's pointless, right? But to my surprise, it looks amazing. The NSLX1 captures even more details. Look closer at the cat's eyes and fur. They are noticeably sharper. The company also claims their laser modulation frequency reaches 20 kHz during the math. With 0.1 mm line spacing and 600 mm per second speed, you need about 6 kHz modulation. So 20 kHz is more than sufficient to ensure precision. A lot of you are probably looking at a powerful data lazy like this for its cutting capabilities. So the real question is, how thick can actually cut? It is a 50mm thick bathsuit and it cut through in just one pass. And check out the cross section, it's super clean. Also worth noting is a massive work area, efficiently advertised as 24 by 18 inches. I use it to build a Star Wars Millennium Falcon and it turned out awesome. One last thing I want to mention is safety and intelligent system management. The X1 is equipped with a smart hardware system that ensures your well-being. With its intelligent assistant, you only need to set the power level. The machine automatically optimizes the air pump, smoke exhaust, and air filtration settings based on your parameters. You don't have to worry about a thing, making the experience smoother and more enjoyable. The entire unit is enclosed in a fire-resistant shell, keeping both you and your workspace protected. So it's truly safe to use. As for the rest of the features, I just list them on the screen for you to explore. And now, my conclusion. After weeks of hands-on testing, I can confidently say that Anycell X1 is just another lazy engraver. It's a huge leap forward in ease of use, performance, and intelligence. From its fully automatic focusing, new 8-megapixel cameras, and intuitive app with real-time previews, to its blazing fast engraving and clean, powerful cutting performance, everything about it feels refined and thoughtfully engineered. Whether you're a total beginner or running a creative studio, the X1 lowers the barrier and opens the door to professional quality laser work without the usual learning curve. If you're as excited about this machine as I am, consider supporting on Kickstarter. Early backers get best deals. And your support will help bring the smart engraver to more creators around the world. I dropped the link below. Go and check it out. Thanks for watching, and Samuel will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.